welcome to your reading for September the 18th through September the 24th. And it's got rather dark here. Excuse my lighting. This is a general reading. I shuffled the cards, seven cards, popped out one for each day of the week, and it's the general energy for that day. This is a general reading, and if you would like a more personalized, focused reading, you'll find that information below in the description box. This is also a sun, moon, and rising reading, so if you know your moon and rising, you can check in the description box because I'll have the links to the other videos down below. So first of all, I want to thank you all for all the love last week. Thank you for the likes, shares, comments, and subscriptions. And I want to thank you in advance for that thumbs up, please, if you like the video. And comments, feedback, sharing if you're inspired. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. So without further ado, let's go to the card, shall we? And on Monday, we have the moon. How apropos, we have the new moon in Virgo. This is coming into an energy of manifestation down to earth, like a really good energy. Now, it's a healing energy. It's a healing energy emotionally, physically, spiritually. So this is a very important time. And look, the moon, when the moon comes up into a card, up into a reading, it means that the truth is being, like the moon is shedding the light on some truth. It's like something is coming, secrets are coming out, right? What's interesting about this coming out now is that, first of all, we're in that energy on Monday of Venus being in a positive aspect to Uranus. And I talked about this last week. It's Sunday, Monday. So if you're watching this early, you might be already feeling it. If you're watching it on Sunday, if not, you know, the Venus is the planet of love and relationships, self-esteem, self-awareness, beauty, what else? Finance and money, and Uranus is like sudden surprises and things coming out of the blue. So this is a very, and it's in a very positive aspect. So we're going to get some, you know, we can expect exciting news coming out of nowhere. So that's really exciting. That's the energy on Sunday and Monday. And then this is going to shed a light on something. Now, also before a new moon, particularly this new moon, because we're going to, it's all about healing. It's healing your emotions and healing your, you know, physically and things, emotions may come up. This is an emotional card, a deep, deep emotional card. Now this, if emotions come, sometimes emotions come up because you need to look at them right before a new moon and you need to release them because you need to move forward and keep going. Now this, look, if emotions come up for you, honor them. Really honor them. Allow them to come to the surface. Allow those emotions go. Look at them, you know, because when you look at them, then you can release them. Sometimes you need that personal time to process those emotions, and that's okay. So that's Monday, right? Tuesday to Wednesday, we've got the new moon going into Virgo. Also, Mercury opposes Neptune in Virgo. So that's like three kind of energies that are kind of opposing. But what comes out of those energies, right, is this amazing kind of creative energy. So it kind of sets the stage to be, you know, creative, to visualize things, to, you know, beautify your home, to think about, you know, having these wonderful ideas and, you know, fantastical ideas. I mean, it's just a lovely, you know, even those energies aren't in the best kind of aspect, it creates this wonderful creative aspect. So on Tuesday, you have the Two of Swords, right? Now this, the Page of Swords, not the Two of Swords. I'm seeing two swords and thought. The pages are known as messengers, right? So this could be an opportunity or two opportunities that come up for you. These could be the surprise, right? The surprises that you're getting from that from the astrological transits that's going on. So you could, you've been offered this gift, and it's two choices. You have two swords, and you have these two opportunities that you need to make a decision on, right? So when the Page of Swords comes in, it's like, go inside and meditate, so you'll know which one to take, which opportunity to take. I don't know, maybe you can take two. I have a feeling you might even be, you're going to get offered these opportunities. And sometimes with this, it's like you've got a choice, but hey, listen, we're in this very powerful energy right now. Maybe you can take both of them, but that's something that you're going to have to decide. Don't do it for greedy reasons if you take the two of them. It's very, very important here to make a decision for the higher good of everyone. So, you know, be discerning about which one you choose, and choose the one that's that feels right and that is for for the good of the higher realm, for the higher you and everyone else. So that's the Page of Swords. And then on Wednesday we have the Eight of Wands. Now this is like this guy, look, he's on the precipice. He's like right on the, and he is expecting his ship to come in. He's looking for it. He knows, he's making plans. He's seeing his ship. Look, see that? The spiritual ship is up there. He's seeing it coming in. He's expecting it. This is saying, look, make optimistic plans. You know, this is a manifesting energy that we're in right now. You know, Pisces, see that. See your ship coming in. Plan to greet your ship. Think about how it would feel to watch your ship come in, right? How wonderful that would feel. Be in that feeling, because the law of attraction is about feeling, not just about the, you know, of course it starts with a thought, but it's the feeling that surrounds that thought is what attracts it, right? So people just like, I've got to think positive. Well, for every positive thought, there's like 8 negative ones, or 10, or you know, hundreds of negative ones saying, hey, that's not going to happen. Anyway, if you focus on the feeling of how that would feel if your ship came in, and you visualize and you imagine your ship coming in and feel that feeling, and it's like, whoa, you're going to attract that ship, darling. So then we have the King of Wands. Darling, this all looks fabulous. Oh my God, your reading looks amazing. It looks really good, Pisces. So, Pisces, we have the King of Wands, who is just creative and fantastic and handsome and fun and always busy. And he's like, he has to be doing something different all the time. So this to me is like a fast energy, darling. This is like really, like things are happening for you, Pisces. This is an exciting time, actually. Pisces, this is brilliant. So that's Thursday, and on Friday, which is the, you know, it's the Libra equinox, the sun moves into Libra, which is more balanced, harmonious energy. This is wonderful, right? We have the Three of Cups. This is celebrate, darling. Listen, on the equinox, you know, a few days later, it's going to moving into this really incredible powerhouse vortex, right? Where galaxies are swirling around. I mean, it's just incredible energy. It's like a new, it's like a global awakening that we're moving into, right? This is exciting. This is the time. Look, the ancients used to do these ceremonies during this time, because they realized how important and how powerful the energies were. So the Three of Cups is celebrate, darling. Celebrate this incredible energy, you know? Things are really happening for you, Pisces. And then on Saturday, we've got the World. And, you know, this is like 21, right? 2 and 1 is 3. 3 is creation. This is like you can create your life. You've got all this life experience, and this is an opportune time for you to change direction. You can start your life purpose now. You can do whatever you want to do. And well, the universe will support you if it's for the higher good of you, and of course if it's not nefarious. So, you know, of course I'm saying, of course you're watching this, so I know you're positive. I know that you would only do it for the, you're going to make changes for the higher good of yourself and everyone involved. So this is saying, darling, this is a good time for you to make that leap of faith and to do what you really want to do. This is the time. The universe is supporting you, Pisces. Now, on Sunday, we have the Queen of Cups. Oh my God, she's such a deep, emotional, wonderful mother. She's just gorgeous. She's just stunning. She's emotionally available. This is like a very powerful, emotional, you know, a leader. This is somebody who's going to put her... she's intuitive. Your intuition and your psychic abilities are enhanced. I mean, already, Pisces, you are psychic and intuitive. You know that. You're very spiritual, and this is your spiritual, your intuitive. Trust your intuition at this time. She's coming through for a reason. So the more you trust on your intuition and your psychic abilities, the more trustworthy they become, right? So this is the definite message. Trust in your intuition and your psychic abilities, Pisces. So lovely. Thank you so much for tuning in, Pisces. I love and I appreciate you all. Mwah. I'll see you next week. For a personal reading, please email Mary at liveinthesolution.com.